So we've ended up at Injune. At a race, a trotting track. Trotting track. There's Maxine, she's got us this far. Injune's about 100 k's north of Roma. And it's only $10 a night to stay here. So the showers and toilets and all that sort of stuff. So just show you a bit of the setup. We've just got there, you got the boss there. Doing some, I think she's making a cuppa now. But yeah, we just got your basic awning. We put a rooftop tent on the trailer. So we could get to some beaches and do some proper real bush camping, because we are self-sufficient. We got all the stuff in the back here. We've got a 1500 watt inverter. That's really only for the kettle there. Oh, it's charging the iPad at the moment. But 138 amp hour deep cycle battery. And a fridge, dual zone fridge. Keeping everything cool. One half frozen, one half fridge. So yeah. And I just wanted to show you how we got everything in the back. We've got a lot of stuff in the trailer. Got a lot of stuff in the trailer that we can, no thanks, we can access. Tools and just all sorts of things. But you've got the gazebo on the back there. That's for when we set up camp for 2 or 3 days. 40 litres of water. I'll eat Janelle, she's gonna get into the fridge now. And we've got a solar panel on the roof there. I don't know whether you can see that or not. Yeah, I've got a solar panel on the roof there. And I've also got a big solar panel there, portable solar panel, that again, if we stay somewhere for a couple of days, we can set all that up and we'll be right. But oh yeah, there's our old, not Max tracks, but the cheap versions. And yeah, so I'll have a cuppa, and there's a few people here. $10 a night, it's pretty bloody good. I hope they don't train the horses at 4 in the morning, but I'm sure we'll be right. Oh yeah, what's for dinner tonight? Pork chops, they're defrosting. A couple of pork chops and I don't know what else he's going to make, but anyway. Yeah, so I'll just show you a few things. So when you like go to bunker down at night, you've got a handle in here that you can pull this down like that, and that's like, you know, if it's pouring rain or whatever, you can keep you nice and comfortable in there. That's a pretty good, it's a pretty good bed. We've got all the comforts of home, all the good stuff, good doonas, pillows. You put your shoes in here, put your shoes in there before you get in the bed, or once you get up on the bed. Yeah, I'll just show you what's going at the back here. So I thought, how do I get everything under here? I've got everything here, like I've got my camp oven. Put the weighty things up the front, and I've got this extra, oh, the butane burner, just in case we run out of gas. And these are just like, oh, mate, it's just everything in here. This is all for washing.
This is, yeah, and then our boots. Got that toilet here. Also got the bush toilet, all the fishing gear, and some chocks if we need them. And just in here, in this one here, is all my like tools if I need anything. He's hoping I don't need anything. But also, before we left, well, 6 months ago, fully done all the trailer up, new springs, just new everything, new bearings.
Just turned off on the road to Carnarvon Gorge, so from here on in it won't be long and we'll be there.
Here at Carnarvon Gorge, or the Carnarvon Gorge campground, just cooking up a bit of lunch. Here we are, all set up. Take the car down to the, like, so we can go for a walk in the gorge, so we can't fully set the car up. But yeah, we've got to get some firewood and have a go at that tonight. And can't wait. Got a bit of ways to go yet, but I know what'll be nice and exciting is this. Thought for sure you were going to fall in.
don't know where we go now, but there's still a track there. Thing we want now is an earthquake. We're in the gorge, can officially say. Nice and cool. See it on a hot day. It'd be bloody beautiful. So we just come out of the gorge, been right up in there. Janelle was scared because she's not right into balance and moving over all these rocks and so on and so forth. Yeah, it's definitely worth the walk in and worth the drive to come and have a look. And this is only one of the gorges. We're having a look at more tomorrow, so. Go and have a look, see what the
can see.
See what we can see at the rock pool. I reckon soak your feet.
So and you might see turtles and platypuses.
Rock pool. Let's go down and have a look. There you go, I'll follow you. Don't fall in. Made it. Leave that there for when you're going back. Let's head up to these rock pools. Let's go back to the log. Here we are. Easy peasy. swim, I think.
So we walked down to this rock pool and we actually seen a platypus swimming around, and we got some footage of it, which we were so pleased with.
So that's all the footage we got of day one and at Carnarvon Gorge. We've just finished walking day two, so we're quite bucket, but wait for the next video. It is it's worthwhile, isn't it?
Definitely is. We're so excited today because we seen the little platypuses in the rock pool. That was so cute.
Yeah, we loved them. They were, never been that close to a platypus, and like it wasn't skittish, it wasn't scared.
It was just swimming around.
Yeah, he was just lapping it up, and it's like he knew that everyone was there. Everyone was there to watch him. But stay tuned for tomorrow.
The next bit.
They're beautiful. The gorges are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Righto, see you then.